Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll be going to explain you various instruction formats and ALU configuration with different computers. You should know, my dear students, with respect to ALU configuration only, there will be instruction formats with given computer. So you should know how ALU executes the instructions. Based on that, you can easily understand how instruction formats may be there. So let us see all those things one by one. So first of all, I'll be explaining you basic ALU structure along with its working so that you can understand how instruction formats can be there. So here, if you observe the basics, then in that you should know, my dear students, instruction formats are there based on how ALU executes the instructions. ALU takes operands as input to perform execution of instructions. Those operands may be there inside registers of CPU or it may be there inside memory, right? So let me explain you first how ALU is there. So you see the basic symbol of ALU, that is something like this. In that, what you will be doing is you will be giving inputs. So here I'm giving my two inputs. Those are my operands. Let us say this is operand 1 and this is operand 2. So here these are the inputs on which this ALU will perform arithmetic and logical task, and here output will be there. You can say that is my result. Here, when any arithmetic and logical task that is been performed by ALU, at that time it will also change the status, and that is been stored inside flag register, or you can say it is been stored inside PSW register, right? And here to ALU we need to give one more input that will define what operation should get performed, right? So various operations can be there, like arithmetic operations may be there. In arithmetic operation we perform addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, right? In logical operation we may perform logic AND operation, logic OR operation, XOR operation, NOT operation. So that is how many logical operations can be there, as well as there can be many other operations like SHIFT operation, right? So here, first of all, we need to give what operation should get performed as input to this ALU, and based on that operation, ALU will take operands as input and it will perform that logical or arithmetic operation and it will produce result over here. And remember one more thing, my dear students, these are not single line input. So here we need to mark dash line, which indicates these are multiple bits line, right? So here you should know, my dear students, ALU will take input as operand on which it will perform arithmetical and logical task. And operation input that will define which kind of operation that will be performed by ALU. Now let us try to understand this same thing along with instruction format. And here one more thing that you need to understand, those operands that may be there inside register of CPU or it may be there at memory location, right? So these operands that may be there inside registers of CPU or it may be there with respect to memory. So here to understand this, you need to understand basic instruction format. Let me show you how it is happening. So first you will be having opcode. That opcode will define what operation should get performed, and here we are having two operands. You see operand 1 and operand 2. So this opcode that will define what should be the operation performed by ALU, and this operands that could be there inside registers, it may be there inside memory, right? So based on CPU format, you will be having those operands, and based on opcode, this ALU will perform task. So you see opcode bits that will define this operation over here, these operands that will be input to this ALU, and based on operation it will perform some arithmetic and logical operation and it will produce a result, right? And along with that it will update the status that will be there inside flag register, or you can say it is there inside PSW register. So based on this understanding, there can be varieties of computers. Let me explain you all those computers one by one. So first I'll explain you how stack computer may be there. So when we talk about stack CPU, then you should know, my dear students, in stack CPU all the operations that will happen with respect to stack only, right? So you see here we are having stack CPU, in that ALU will perform all the operation with respect to stack data only. Both operands of ALU are always there on stack. Stack is working as per last in first out, and default addresses are there on top of stack only, right? As in stack, it is performing operation based on last input, first output. So default address that will be there on top of stack. Here you don't need to have any address for operand as it is already there on stack, right? So if you see the instruction format, so in that you'll be having opcode only. Why? The reason is you don't need to have address of operands. Why? The reason is operands will be there inside stack only, right? So here you'll be observing that stack insertion and deletion that will happen at the same time. Now to understand this, let me explain you one practical example so that will gives you more clarity. So here what I'll be doing is I'll be considering one example in which I'll be performing one arithmetical and logical task. In that I want to perform R4 is equals to R1 plus R2 into R3. So when you talk about stack CPU, my dear students, remember one thing: you don't need address of operands. The reason is operands are well defined, it is fixed. It is working with respect to stack memory. So stack memory is working as per last in first out, right? So by default operands will be there as per top of stack only. So here you will not be specifying operands in instruction format, there will be only opcode. So to understand that, let us try to understand this example. So here, my dear students, what I'll do is I'll write instructions over here and I'll show you how stack memory is there over here, right? Here initially let us assume stack memory is empty. Now see, we want to perform R1 plus R2 into R3 and we want to store that inside R4. So initially R1 and R2, that we need to place it on stack. So what we will be doing is you'll be writing push R1 first. So what it will do, it will store R1 on top of stack. Now see, initially it is empty, so here R1 will get stored over here. Again when you write push R2, what will happen? This R2, now that you will be storing on top of stack. So here we have already stored R1, so now R2 will get stored over here. Now see, these two operands are there on stack. So now with the use of addition, you can perform R1 plus R2. Here you don't need to specify operand. Why? The reason is it is already there on stack. So you just need to write add. Now here you are not writing add R1 plus R2. Why? The reason is by default in stack CPU, it will consider these operands only, right? So what it will do, it will add R1 and R2 and it will store it on stack. So you see here what it does is it will delete this data and here it will store R1 plus R2. So you see, stack insertion and deletion take place at the same time. So once it takes these operands, it will perform arithmetical task, it will delete this data, right? And it will store R1 plus R2 over here. Now you see what we want to do, R1 plus R2 into R3. So into R3, that we need to do. So R3, that I need to push it on stack. So I'll be writing push R3. So what will happen with the same data? Now already we have R1 plus R2 over here, and as per push R3 on top of stack, R3 will get pushed over here. Now we have two operands over here, you see these two. So in that we need to perform multiplication. So what we'll be doing is now we'll be performing multiplication operation, and you don't need to specify operands over here, right? So what will happen now, multiplication of these two data will happen and it will get stored over here in stack only with the deletion of this data. So here R1 plus R2 into R3, that will be stored over here in stack memory. Now you want to have this in which register? R4. So now by writing pop R4, you can take this data right back on register R4. So now this stack memory, that will get empty again. Why? The reason is pop means we will be taking data out of the stack memory. So here in stack CPU, if you observe, operands are by default there with the stack memory. So you don't need to give operands in instruction formats, right? So that is how instruction format is there. By default, stack memory is connected with ALU as a operand over here. Now I'll explain you accumulator CPU. Let us try to understand those things. So when you talk about accumulator CPU, so in accumulator CPU, my dear students, one special resistor that will be accumulator, that will be there inside CPU. So accumulator, that will be one by default operand of that ALU, right? And second operand, that may be resistor or memory. So after arithmetic and logical operation, answer will get stored inside accumulator, and one operand that will be always there with accumulator, only we need to have second operand in the instruction, right? The reason is one operand that will be by default inside accumulator. So here, let me show you how structure is there first. So as we have seen, ALU, in that basically what we do is we perform arithmetic and logical task. In that, as per accumulator CPU, by default operand that will be accumulator, right? This will be by default operand. Second operand, that may be resistor or it may be there inside memory, and based on these two operands, ALU will perform operation and result will get stored back inside accumulator, right? So if you observe here instruction format, in that we need to have opcode. This opcode will define what should be the operation of this ALU, and this operand that may be there inside resistor or memory. So that is second operand of this ALU. So that is how configuration is there with accumulator CPU, right? Now I'll explain you one practical example so that will improve your understanding further. So here we want to perform R4 is equals to R1 plus R2 into R3. So you see here ALU is having by default operand accumulator. So first of all, one data that should be there inside accumulator. So what I'll do is first I'll be performing R1 plus R2. So out of this, I need to take R1 or R2 inside accumulator. So what I'll be doing is first I'll be moving that R1 data inside accumulator, right? So here move A comma R1, what it means? R1 data that will get copied inside A. So here in RTL, resistor transfer language, I'll be writing this. You see now accumulator that will be having content of R1. Now once you have one data inside accumulator, you can perform arithmetic operation. So now you can write add R2. So what it will do? It will add accumulator with R2. You see R1 is already there with accumulator. So here what will happen? Now new content that will be there inside accumulator only, you see, and here it will be performing R2 plus A, right? So that is practically R1 plus R2. Now we want to perform multiply by R3. So here you'll have to write MUL R3. So what will happen? Accumulator and R3, that will get multiplied over here and it will get stored inside accumulator, right? So in RTL language, you can say accumulator content, now that will be initial accumulator content, that is R1 plus R2 into R3. Now we want to store that in which resistor? R4. So now again, you will have to move the data of accumulator, that is my result, inside R4. So in RTL language, you see what we are doing is we are having now R4, that is accumulator's content. So in accumulator CPU, we'll be storing result inside accumulator after arithmetic operation, right? Now I'll explain you general purpose instruction formats along with its ALU. So here in general purpose, my dear students, it is not compulsory that you will be having accumulator as one operand, right? There can be any operand which may be there inside resistors or memory. So first of all, I need to show you that by one ALU. So here we are having ALU, you can observe, and with that we will be having two operands. You see operand 1 and operand 2, and here I'll be having my result, right? So you see instruction format that is there as per this only, where these two operands that may be there inside resistor of CPU or it may be there inside memory, and based on operation, what will happen? Based on operation, it will produce result, it will perform arithmetic task or logical task, and along with that it will update flag, or you can say status, right? So that is how basic format is there. Now I'll explain you one practical example. So same thing that we want to perform here. See, opcode that will define what should be our operation. And here what I'll do is I'll write a program, right? So now see here R1 plus R2, when you want to perform this at a time by simply writing add, then R1 comma R2, what will happen? It will perform addition of these two and the result will get stored inside R1. So R1 will be now R1 plus R2. As you can have any two operands, it may be there inside memory or register, right? So you see in the instruction format, it is given over here. So now you have performed this. Now you want to perform what? R1 into R3. So now you can write MUL R1 comma R3. So what it does? Now it will be performing R1 is equals to R1 into R3, right? Multiplication means multiplication of these two and answer will get stored inside R1. Now result is there inside R1. That you want to store it inside R4. So now you can move this inside R4. So R4 comma R1 means now R4 will be having content of R1. So that is how general purpose CPU is there, right? Now, my dear students, there can be varieties of formats available with respect to CPU, right? So in that, there may be three operands, or you can say three address instructions. There may be four address instructions. So let me show you that also. So here, when you want to understand those things, then first of all, you need to see how instruction format is there. So in instruction format, you see three address instruction format that is having opcode over here. That opcode will define what should be the operation and there will be three addresses. You see, I'm writing A1, A2, A3. Those are my operands, right? And here, my dear students, we are having three addresses, right? So here you don't need accumulator inside that by default operand. Why? The reason is already we are specifying three addresses. So here you'll be observing this opcode will define operation and you'll be having three operands, right? So these are operands. And in this, you don't need to have spatial resistors. Why? The reason is that is used for spatial function only, like we have seen it for the case of accumulator, right? So here you don't have accumulator as operand, which will be by default operand, right? Now I'll explain you four address instructions. So first box that will be there regarding opcode, and next four are addresses, right? So I'm writing A1, A2, A3 and A4. Now in this type of instruction, you'll be observing this opcode will show you what will be the operation, right? And here you'll be having A1, A2, A3 that will be as operands. But this A4, that will be address of next instruction. This A4, that will be address of next instruction. Now you might be thinking like, why should we have this A4 as address of next instruction? The reason is, in this type of instruction format of CPU, you don't have program counter. See, program counter will be pointing address of next instruction, right? But in four address instruction, address of next instruction, that will be there in this box, that is A4. So in that, you don't have program counter with this type of CPU. So that is how things are there, my dear students. You will be observing in three address instruction, you will be observing you don't have accumulator as a by default operand of that ALU, right? You can say you don't have accumulator over here. As well as in four address instruction, you don't have program counter. Why? The reason is next instruction address, that is itself defined inside instruction format, right? So you don't need to have program counter in this type of CPU. And there can be many questions based on this instruction formats. In future coming videos, I'll be solving problems. Definitely that will make sure how you can solve the questions. I hope it is clear to you. Thank you so much for watching this video.